Now, the north has been absolutely pummeled by rain this year with record floods and slips.
So with all this extra rain, how do we create a system that can manage stormwater and reduce the risk of floods? Well, the experts say nature knows best. Here's Lucas de Jong.
They lie under our major cities, unseen, but always working to carry away our water.
Underneath here and underneath the motorway are enormous stormwater pipes. What happened in anniversary weekend is the rain was just too much for those pipes, and this whole area here, this whole field flooded.
Mangere was hit hard. Thousands of low-lying houses were flooded.
Are we ever going to be able to build pipes that can handle this sort of rain?
You're never going to get a big enough pipe to handle that. And so we really have to start thinking about infrastructure in a different way.
So probably the last 70 years we've tried to channelise and contain stormwater. What we're turning to now is a more natural solution.
It's called daylighting.
So daylighting is when you take the stream out of the pipe and put it back to the light, basically.
Taking away the concrete and letting nature do what it's always done. Walmsley Park is a perfect example.
This was a metre and a half concrete lined channel with soggy grass coming into it. So yeah, it's quite a transformation. And the stream is quite highly engineered, but we're trying to mimic nature.
To try and build a pipe that would capture the same amount of what I'm seeing here in this area, that's a very big pipe.
It would be huge. We'll just go broke trying to build infrastructure big enough to cater for these events.
On the North Shore, Hooton Reserve was designed with rain in mind.
And so just downstream from where we are is the township of Albany, and we knew there was going to be flooding. The Lucas Creek would flood with all the new stormwater from Albany, but also the upper catchment.
This entire area was underwater in the Auckland floods, and that's exactly what it was designed to do.
We deliberately built a terrace next to the stream, which would be park, but when the stream did flood, that would flood and the people's activity would be on the next terrace up.
It's about trying to slow the water, using plants and nature to act as a citywide sponge, a concept that Unitech's landscape architect students are embracing.
And now we have to study our planting in the reserve, planting alongside the water stream to stop the flooding.
There's the specific native species that work in every single niche in Auckland that will actually not just improve like the quality of the water, but the stability of the ground.
Because the benefits of daylighting go far beyond flood resistance.
When you build green infrastructure or open the streams up, you have multiple functions. You have amenity, you have a higher ecological value.
Releasing the drain can have a huge impact on the community.
And the fish are migrating up and down, and the insects are metamorphosing. There's life cycles, there's food webs.
Julia's stream team have been transforming Te Ararata Creek into a place she's proud of.
If we are going to have a balance in our cities, we're going to have people looking after their own environment, because council cannot cope with the maintenance of all these areas, especially as they expand.
And that's the council's plan. More open waterways that serve a purpose for people, plants, animals, and stormwater.
Well, what I'm excited about is building more of this, you know, turning almost what we've been doing in the last 70 years, naturalising it again.
We've really got to kind of rethink how our landscape works in Auckland, and we do that by taking the water out of the pipes.